I love this lab, for example. Everything I need is here. Anything to encourage me and share my expertise of biology with my students. Not all the students develop the same way of learning. And I have to reach each student. If my student gets an F and he's there every day coming up to my lecture, it's not the student that failed, it's me that failed. And we don't prepare the student just to get grade A. We prepare them also for bachelor degree, to get master degree, to be successful in life. One major objective is to teach a student teamwork. Students may learn it better from the student. This is why you see tables here with four chairs. Lab is an occasion for them to work as a team and to empower themselves.
I picked this spot because it's this beautiful entryway into Richland's campus, and it's the start of so many passages for people's higher education. Richland is so filled with students from all over the globe. So we get these different and unique experiences with age, with cultures, with spirituality. They come with so many different backgrounds. On the first day of class, we work hard on saying each other's names correctly. We want to bring in who you are and what you are, but embracing all those wonderful students also means that there's not a single learning style that's the same. Group learning, individual learning, small group learning, pairing off, that all happens in our classroom. We have to incorporate other materials or instructions are provided electronically, also provided verbally, because not all students know how they learn yet. They haven't even figured that out about themselves, if they're visual, verbal, or kinesthetic.
I selected an area near one of the bridges because these bridges to me symbolize connections. And the thing I enjoy most is thinking about the connections that I see students making on the bridges, making friends, establish relationships, learning about each other's cultures, international students from different parts of the world getting to know each other. It's always good, I think, to have campuses such as Richland where students can have that face-to-face contact, and you need to have inclusion and diversity to understand history. As we look back in history, we see more and more periods where many people were not allowed to participate politically or were not allowed to get an education. We can see how important it is that we include people from all walks of life.
I walk along this breezeway, so I get to see students from all over the world, and I just feel like it's such an inclusive campus that really represents who I am as a person, and so it makes me really proud to be here. May peace prevail on earth signs all over the place, and it just feels like a place of inclusion and a place of equity that encourages different people, and I just feel like it's a place of hope. Inclusion starts from the very first moment that anybody walks into my classroom. Students who literally can only answer name, country, language, and then it gets into full-on conversation by the end of level 8. The most important thing that I do in my classroom is build an atmosphere of respect where everybody is included, no matter what their background is. Then they are ready to learn. They learn how to work with everybody, no matter what the language barriers are, the social barriers, everybody just gets to work together. It really is just like a family. We talk about our families. That's a lot of the subject material that I use so they can practice the new English.
I chose the library for equity because my students all come to the classroom with different needs. Inclusion means embracing all. I'm immediately making a connection with them, with an atmosphere that they want to be in. I do a lot of icebreakers, so I learn a lot about the students. They also learn a lot about me. If they know they're going into a classroom where that instructor knows them personally, they're more likely to be more successful and more engaged and want to be there and participate. We have a classroom that has a lot of respect. I respect my students, and I command respect from them. I also want to make sure if one student's speaking, no one else is speaking. We are giving that same respect to foster respect. I believe it comes with high expectations.
I'm standing here to welcome my ESL students. Their diversity energizes me, all that they bring, their different countries, religions, cultures, customs, and so on. Inclusion for me means no discrimination in my classroom. Anybody and everybody is welcome, irrespective of race, sex, religion. I promote positive self-esteem, acceptance, respect, and I do this by using cooperative learning techniques in my class. Everybody has to cooperate with their classmates and partners, irrespective of age or country or anything else. Everybody is welcome. No matter the differences, we focus on the commonalities. I project the sense of unity in diversity. I also use the world map. Ask the students to show me where they come from. And some students have never heard of certain countries. And that is a kind of a binding factor. It makes you realize the world is such a big place besides your country. And so automatically they develop a sense of respect.